This is a Sports 5 production of the Philippine Superliga.
Nagpapatuloy po ang paluwang walang humpay dito po sa May San Juan Arena as we bring you the second game of our opening day doubleheader. Ang inyo pong all-Filipino defending champions, ang Chi Active Spikers, ay matatawag nating ladies on a mission dahil gusto nilang depensa ng kanilang corona para manatiling reyna ng mga Pinay Spikers. Pero ang sasalubong sa mga kampiyon ay ang mga toplanders na kapwa mga kampiyon din na gustong patunayan na kaya nilang maging kampiyon nang walang reinforcements. It's a new day for the champions, mga kaibigan. Ito po ang bakbakan ng dalawang kampiyon, ang Petron Tri-Active Spikers at ng Photon Top Landers. Volleyball fans sa buong kapuluan, magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Welcome po sa inyong PSL All-Filipino Conference 2016. Chiki Reyes po, kasama si Chiki Pablo at kami inyong napapanood ng live sa Action TV, ang Philippine Olympic Network. And Chik, umpisahan na natin to. Buena mano tayo, ang swerte naman natin, second game ng ating opening day at champions agad ang magtatapat.
That's right. Alam mo, ang Petron has won a number of championships here in the PSL and they currently hold the record of 13 wins and 0 losses in the conference. Pero ang Photon was a team or the team that stole a championship from Petron during the 2015 Grand Prix. So you can just imagine kung gaano ka mainit ang bakbakan na to.
Puntahan natin yung sinabi mo, 13-0. Let's call that a blazing sweep.
Yes.
Dahil nga itong mga mamamalo ng Petron. Aba, noong komperensyang iyan, sabi nila kami ang team to beat dito. Pero partner, mawawalan sila or nawalan sila ng mga pangalang Dakis, Maranyo, and the Big D. The question now is, can they defend that crown without those top players in their roster?
You know, those three names that you mentioned are very important players, but volleyball is a game of team sport. It's not really for individual players. Having said that, you can still bank on names like Isa Pontillas, like CJ Rosario, who's very new. Well, not really new. She was here in the Invitational, but she takes on the role of a middle hitter. And of course, si Seth, napaka-smart player in the Open.
Tingnan natin. Alam ko, papunta ka na dun sa mga manlalaro ng Petron, pero silipin natin, sino ba yung mga bagong players? You mentioned a couple of names already. There's the complete list. CJ Rosario, second pick sa ating draft. At very promising ang karyer ng batang ito.
Yes, tapos nandyan din si Bernadette Pons.
Okay.
Na galing FEU. A smart hitter din yan. Pati si, of course, nandyan din yung iba-iba pang players dyan eh.
Yes. Marami. And they're backed up by a good coach, of course.
Of course, George Pascua.
Diba? Okay, so one side of the fence done. Puntahan natin yung kabila. Ang Photon Toplanders. Ito sa kabila naman, aba, Cinderella finish ang nangyari sa kanila. Because when they were playing All-Filipino, people said, naku po, ano nangyari sa kampanya ng Photon? But when they were backed up by Lindsay Stalzer and Katie Messing, aba, sila ang nanaig na kampiyon sa ating Grand Prix.
Yeah, and during the off-season, ang Photon talagang did their homework. Nag-beef up sila sa team nila. And now, their team is so deep that a good problem that Coach Villette has right now is who to pick as the first six.
Alam mo, I was going around the two different dugouts kanina at ang laki ng ngiti sa aking mukha sapagkat when I saw the players from Petron and player from Photon, ang hula ko agad, five-setter. Kaya tingnan natin ang lineup ngayon ng Photon Toplanders because I'm sure we have very nice and promising names the same way na meron mga veterano na ba matatawag natin dito because katingin ko, mano-imano, aabutin tayo ng limang set sa labang ito.
Palagay ko nga, pero of course, dito makikita natin sa listahan ang Photon, their go-to player will really be Jaja Santiago because she's 6'6".
Yes.
And if she jumps really high to her peak, who can block her? At nandyan din si Dana Henson, Cici Rondina as the open hitters, one of the new faces that, you know, we have to watch out for.
Mga kaibigan, walang bibitaw sa inyo sa aming pagbabalik. Bakbaka na po ng Triactive Spikers at ng Toplanders. We'll be right back.
Isidro Hugo International Referee. Our second referee, Jesus Jess Villarreal, National Referee. Now let us meet the starters. First, for the Petron Tri-Active Spikers. Number 7, Francis Molina. Number 1, Grace Masangkay. Number 3, Bernadette Pons. Number 9, Remy Palma. Number 13, Micah Morada. Team captain, number 8, Isa Maizo Pontillas. Their libero is number 6, Bang Pineda. And the head coach of Petron Tri-Active is George Pascua. And now let's meet the Photon Tornadoes. Number 1, Rhea Dimaculangan. Number 10, Micah Ortiz. Number 12, Carol Cerveza. Number 7, E.J. Laure. Number 3, Jaja Santiago. Number 16, Cherry Rontina. Their libero is number 11, Bia General. And the head coach of the Photon Tornadoes, Vilette Ponce de Leon.
There you have it, folks, our protagonists para po sa ating second game ng ating opening day doubleheader ng inyong Philippine Super League All-Filipino Conference, Petron at Photon. For the Triactive Spikers, it's Pons, Palma, Masangkay, Maizo Pontillas, Morada, Molina, and of course, Bang! Pineda as libero. Sa kabila naman for Photon, they have Santiago, Rondina, Dimaculangan, Cerveza, Laure, Ortiz, and General as the starting libero. We are excited. My partner and I, Chicky Razor with Chicky Pablo. Mamaya, to complete our TV broadcast, we got Carla Lizardo manning the sides. And of course, our referees. First referee, Jojo Hugo, international referee. And second referee, Jess Villarreal, national referee. Aren't you excited, partner?
Sobrang excited. Counting the minutes ako the moment I woke up this morning.
Here we go. Petron, mostly in red. Counting blue. Habang ang kanilang katapat, ang Photon, na siyang nakakuha ng unang puntos, nakakulay asul, mostly blue naman po ang kanilang uniforme.
Of course, alam mo, ang Photon really has to come out strong to make a statement dahil siyempre defending champions itong katapat nila.
Yes. Nagkaroon pa ng
service error.
Kaya tablagad tayo, one apiece. I like the crowd here at San Juan Arena. Talagang inintay nila matapos ng ating beach volleyball, matapos ng ating draft. Everyone was waiting for this opening day.
Tama. At paano naman ang lalakas ng mga teams, 8 teams battling in this All-Filipino Conference.
The captain scoring on that hit. At alamang dito ang Petron, 2-1. Alam mo, kanina nung first game natin covered by James Velasquez and Tex Suter, abay, wala akong marinig, kundi puro hiyaw ng fans dito.
Excited talaga. Ang ganda naman kasi ng mga ginagalaw ng panalaro natin. You know, speaking of Photon,
yes.
Ang Photon in statistics, they're younger, they're taller in terms of blocking and service and spikes. They have a higher average compared to Petron's. But Petron, resilient, mabilis ang recovery, at you know, they've been together for a long time, matinding katapat pa rin, even if the statistics say that higher ang percentage ng Photon.
But so far, we are tied here at set 1-2 apiece. Triactive Spikers on the hit. Toplander, sila naman ang susubok. Great net defense shown by Petron. Ladies in red will not fail on that one. At the net, nanaig ang Triactive Spikers.
Bernadette Pons, talagang kinalaban niya ang matinding blocker na si Judge Santiago sa harap niya. No fear hitting that ball over.
At ang magsaserve ngayon for Petron, Remy Palma, binanggit mo to off the air.
Yes.
Meron kang na-research dito, partner.
Oh, itong si Remy Palma from FEU. She's one of the players that we all have to watch out for. She's got a strong hand. Good nga lang sa service niya, displayed really strong hand ng outside ng kanyang hits. But, you know, we have to wait for her to perform in this game.
Alam mo, kahit na gano'ng kaka-veterano, kahusay, pag ganito karami ang nanonood, those butterflies in your tummies will always be there. Muntik na ka makapunto si Chacha, pero palo ni Kapitan, pasok.
Alam mo, perfect ng timing ni Aiza Pontillas. Even though you've got tall blockers in front of her, she went up, hit that ball right when the blockers of Poton were going down. Kaya nakalusot yung bola niya.
At lamang dito ang Petron, 4-3. First set pa lang po ito. Ladies in blue, they go to the back. Great four defense, AC with a set. Great net defense shown by the taller players of Photon. Meantime, Chacha with a powerful hit. And the message was heard loud and clear.
Fierce hit there from Chacha Santiago, whom I talked to earlier this afternoon. Eto, look at that. There was just a single blocker that went up against her. You cannot have a single blocker when Chacha's up in the air.
Tabla tayo. For all. Set number one. Bawi kaya dito ang Petron, Laure. Meantime, Toplanders. Ortiz going to the back. Ball is still alive. Subok muli ang Photon. Back set. Oh, look at the net defense. But the ladies are smiling on this side of the court. Chacha blocked at the net.
Alam mo, nabasa nila that the ball of Chacha wasn't gonna be that strong because she hit that ball from behind the attack line. As you can see, she goes up.
And this Petron Tracted block is brought to you by Petron. Petron Tracted fuels better engine protection, better mileage, better power.
Nakalusot yung bola in between the blockers, pero kuwang-kuwa eh. Kuwang-kuwa ng
nabasa.
Petron. Nabasa ng Petron.
5-4 lamang ang Petron. Service error mula kay Aiza Maiza Pontillas. And that means tabla tayo, Jake, at 5-all here in set number one. Meantime, Cerveza will be serving for the Toplanders. 5 apiece ang ating score. Muntik pang maging alas yun. Oh, there's a donut there. There's a big space.
Nicely done by Micah Morada. Tinignan niya muna eh, yung floor defense ng Photon. Anong galaw nila? Nabasa niya, walang pupunta sa gitna. That's where she brought the ball.
The beauty of the off-speed, ano? Hindi naman ganun kabilis, but the
on
curve
target.
Was right.
Yeah.
Petron, abante ng isa, 6-5. Make it 2-point lead for Petron, 7-5.
No, itong si Micah Morada really gives a wicked serve. Eh. Kaya may expect may mga service aces from her. So Photon has to be more prepared when she's serving. Ooh!
Morada with a service error. Bakit pa ganun? Sa tuwing babanggitin natin yung magandang ginagawa ng manlaro.
Oo nga, na-excite sila.
Kahit
sila,
basketball
no?
Or volleyball.
Bakit
nga ba? It's the sportscaster's jinx. EJ Laure, mamaya may kwento tayo dyan pag na-focus mamaya ni Direk ang kanyang pamilya na very into sports. Meantime, Triactive Spikers will try once more going to zone one. That's out. Too much muscle behind the hit of Palma.
Palma was under the ball. That's why it went high and it went long.
Tied at 7 ang ating set number one. Sa kabila naman, Photon will try to get the lead here. Palma will try again. And that point will go to Photon. At namang ho ang Photon ng isa, 8-7, as we go to our first technical timeout of set number one.
Nakatuto pa rin kayo sa
the Philippine Super League All-Filipino Conference 2016. Sabi ni Coach Villette Ponce de Leon that the first thing that they did during the offseason was to make their new players feel comfortable. Importante daw yan kasi in order for them to really bring out their game. Yan daw talaga ang family culture nitong Photon. Dagdag ni Coach Villette that their lineup is actually very unpredictable right now because they have several players who can play multiple positions. And as much as possible, they will have no superstars. Everyone will get equal opportunities. Chiki and Chiki.
Maraming salamat sa iyo, Carla. Meantime, eto na. Yung sinasabi mong mahusay pumalo, malakas pumalo. Remy Palma scoring on that one.
Yeah, ito si Remy Palma, just give her the ball na yung comfortable with, nakakatakot ang resulta nun.
Score po natin, tablas na 8. At ace, ang binitawan ni Molina for Petron there, up 9-8.
Alam mo, dun nga sa, ano, sa report ni Carla, importante talaga yung magkaroon ng bonding ang isang team eh, because
yes,
you've got different personalities, different character traits. So, kailangan maayos yun para maayos sila inside the court.
And so far, itong dalawang koponan, maliban dun sa koponan ni Coach Villette, both teams are actually, I think, playing good music together in set one.
That's right.
Still tied at 9. Great floor defense by Molina. Toplanders on the other side. Oh, great hit coming from Rondina.
Cici Rondina excitedly hit that ball. Love her reaction.
There look
goes,
at that.
Yeah, here goes that setup. Ang layo niya sa net.
Oh!
Pero naman, lusok na lusok yung bola.
And we saw her jump the same
yeah
height or same hops kahit na nung nasa beach volleyball.
Walang pinagkaiba ang sand at ang ano, sahig para kay Cici Rondina. That was a good hit there once again.
That's the second donut that we saw
yes
sa depensa dito ng Photon.
Oo, kaya sunod-sunod yung Waterloo nila eh, nangyayari dyan sa gitna. So kailangan bantayan nila yan.
Pero tira mo ang score natin, Chiki P. We are very close in this first set, 10-9. Petrona Bante lang ng isa. Masangkay will set quick one to Palma.
Ito si Palma, basta binigyan siya ng bola, talagang target niya patayin yung bola eh, no? Find the floor.
It's not the prettiest of hits. Kalimutan mo yung tunog ng magandang tunog ng palad na tumatama sa bola. But as long as it's a point,
that's right,
they'll take it. Talking about Petron. 11-9, lamang ng dalawang defending champions ng All-Filipino. Gawin yung 12-9 dahil tatlo na ang kanilang abante.
Ang ganda ng ginawa ni AC because Remy Palma kept delivering the points for Petron. So para hindi mabantayan si Palma, gumawa siya ng play na combination. And the one that finished that play was not Remy Palma.
Bernadette Poncion.
There you go.
Ball is still alive. The captain will score again. And it's so difficult to guard a lefty.
It's so difficult to guard a smart lefty.
Diba?
Yeah.
13-9, may timeout tayo dito. I'm sure si Coach Villette would like to talk things over. Pero another look at this great set by AC. Dalawa tumalon. Kontra dito kay Aisa. Found the space, went cross-court. Dahil dyan, apat ang abante ng Petron Tri-Active Spikers. Let's listen in. Oh, check, tinan mo dun sa timeout na yun, ha? Walang croquis, walang play. Ginawa ni Coach Millet, pinakalma yung mga manlalaro ng Photon. Relax.
That's right. Habol, sabi niya.
Di ba?
Yes. And also, to break the momentum.
Tingnan natin kung yung ganong estilo. Oh, nagbunga agad. Hindi. Malakas ang palo ni Jaja. I thought I was a check ball there. But Jaja missing on that one. But still, I see a more relaxed 6 here. Para kay Coach Villette. They're down 14-9. AC serving for Petron. Service error.
Alam mo, nakita ko yun eh. When she released the ball, parang hinabol niya yung bola eh before she hit it. That's why that ball went to the net.
Very crucial yung preparation.
Yeah. And you're given 8 seconds. So kung pangit ang tapon mo ng bola, pabagsak mo na lang siya sa floor.
Ah.
And then you serve again.
We've seen a lot of players take their sweet time.
Yeah.
Si Big D dati, di ba? Ang tagal ng kanyang seremonyas. All right, balik tayo sa live action. Chacha defended at the net, but the ball is still alive. CC with a hit. Sa kabila, Aisa, cross court, favorito.
Si Aisa, yung bola niya, pinapadaan din niya sa smaller blocker ng Photon. Tapos, anggulong-anggulo pa ang hit niya. There goes that setup. There's a big gap between the blockers. Jaja was late, so pasok yung bola niya.
At limang abante ng Petron, 15-10. And another service error coming from Remy Palma. Maniniwala na ako sa'yo. Malakas nga pumalo.
Malakas pumalo.
Second service error ni Remy. Pero siguro may kasama na rin ano yan. Ang opening game jitters.
Oh, tsaka excited yan. First time eh, sa PSL.
Oh, that's a name that you guys should follow. Meantime, Toplanders, Laure, scoring on that hit off a deflection.
There were two blockers in front of her. She goes up. Ang ganda ng arm swing niya. Gumulong pa yung bola niya sa net, and that really helped her a lot.
Kausap ko yung parents ito. Direct hire.
Ano daw? Wow.
Mamaya, focus siya, matutuwa ka dahil full support yan. Samantalang si Pons pumuntos muli for Petron. 16-12 ang ating score. Apat ang abante ng Triactive Spikers. Second technical timeout. Ito, pag-usapan natin ang mga rookies ng Petron Triactive Spikers. Bernadette Pons, Remy Palma, and number two pick, CJ Rosario.
Bernadette Pons and Palma are both from FEU. At si Coach George, FEU, so the system is the same. Kaya malaking bagay yun.
Sa kabila, for Photon, you got Henson, EJ Laure, Carol Cerveza, Che Rondin, or CC Rondin, and Shirley Salamagos.
Yun yung sinasabi ko eh, na talagang nag-beef up ang Photon during the off-season, making sure that their team is a tough contender for the All-Filipino Conference.
At volleyball fans, kaya po namin na gustong ipakita sa inyo ang mga pangalang ito. Sapagkat kayo po ay pinasisikat o sumisikat sila sa PSL, but later on, sila na ang magiging muka, no?
Oh.
Ng volleyball dito sa Pilipinas. 17-12, Chiki. 5-point lead para sa defending champions.
Ine-expect mo talaga yun dahil sila yung defending, but Photon is doing a good job hustling. Oh, wow!
How often do you see that?
You don't often see that. Nagtinginan ang ating Petron Reactive Spikers.
Normally, nangyayari yan sa reception, di ba? Sa receive.
Yeah.
Iyo akin.
Oo.
Pero on the second ball,
nagkaroon ng confusion.
But the Photon will welcome those errors anytime.
Good save there by AC Misangkay.
Once again, Photon on the attack. Cerveza scoring on that hit.
Ang hirap din kasi bantayan ni Cerveza kasi she's left-handed. There goes that great setup from Rhea de Makulangan. Kabisado niya ang kamay ni Cerveza. Nicely done.
Score natin, 17-14, partner. Tatlo na lang abante rito ng Petron. Aiza, not going cross-court, going down the line, pero andun si CC. Meantime, AC knew it. Masangkay knew it na maganda yung pagkakapalo ni Carol.
Cerveza, talagang, dito kasi sa Photon, pag tinignan mo yung mga manlalaro nila ngayon, you can go to anybody because anybody can deliver. Cerveza is making a name for herself. CC Rondina, we've seen her in beach volleyball. Rhea de Makulangan, matagal na yung kilalang magaling na setter.
Molina saw an opening in zone one.
Yes, and she knew that Jaja Santiago was still there at the back, kaya mabagal ang galaw ng middle. So, doon pinapunta ni Molina ang kanyang bola. Nicely done. Smart move.
18-15, tatlo abante ng Triactive Spikers. And this is what you're telling me earlier, Chick. No? Up. Kalma lang. Pag narinig mo yung pito, gather yourself. That's a good serve.
Yeah. Cerveza again.
Oh, too much muscle behind the hit. And that point will go to Petron.
So ito, dapat i-distribute ni Rhea ang kanyang, kanyang sets na hindi lang puro kay Cerveza. Because you have to also give her a chance to rest a little bit, catch her breath. Because andiyan naman si Ortiz in the middle.
Oh, oh, the tip was her ally. Talking about Negrito.
Oh, baka hindi pa siya masyadong nakakahinga. Buti na lang sumabit yung bola niya sa net. But then that would have been a quick point for Photon.
So the Triactive Spikers are up by 5 against the Tornadoes. 20-15 ang ating score. Photon on the attack. Laure. Sa kabila naman, free ball itong ibabalik sa Photon. They need to score here. Soft touches. No, saved by Molina.
Oh.
Yun nga lang, kinapos na si Negrito on the third ball.
That's right. Pero alam mo yung nangyari doon kay Ortiz? Ha, nauna yung talon niya. Yung bababa na siya, na doon sa peak naman yung bola. Buti na lang, matangkad si Ortiz, nagawa niya ng paraan.
GNP.
Ginawa ng paraan, no? Yes.
20 or 16, serving 20, Tyvee Perez.
This is a good front line for Photon. You've got Ortiz and Araneta. Araneta's gonna be playing the opposite.
Tingnan natin yan. Pero si Mina says, nope. Let's inch in closer to get set number one. That's the 21st point of Petron.
Sabi ni Mina, walang kaso. Kung nandiyan si Araneta, carry lang.
And Angeli Araneta is the captain,
yes,
incidentally, of the Photon Tornadoes. And pasok yun, ha?
That is a good serve. Oh,
I saw the antenna move, but pasok. Diba?
Sa line siya bumagsak.
Oh, 22-16, 6-point lead para sa Triactive Spikers. Assistant Coach Villette.
Hindi mahirap yung bola nila. Hindi, pwesto-pwesto na nga lang. Hindi naman kagado, eh. Diba? Oh, ipatasin lang natin yung bola. Yung block natin sobrang lambob. Ano ba? Yung chef, tumempo kayo, tapos pag nasa taas kayo, pinasan nyo naman ang konti para naman may, hindi yung pinapadaanan lang tayo ng bola. Okay? Ngayon, yung gitlang yan, matcheck pa, tumamasin yung bola. Pwede ba someone? Take five.
Let's go! Ready?
Yes.
Coach Villette said, ang palo nila, hindi ganun ka-powerful. Ang problema, yung blocks natin, ang nalambot.
Oo nga. Tsaka hindi nakapayong. Oh. Kaya ang sinasabi ni Coach Villette, pwede ba block harder?
Uh-huh.
Kasi importante yun. And watch out for zones 5 and 6 again. Kasi doon lagi bumabagsak yung ball eh.
And Chen Una gives Photon a free point. Yeah. Cutting their lead down to 5.
That's a much needed point for Photon.
Para lang mahinto yung ano, na ginagawang rally ng Petron.
Oh.
EJ Laure, ang sabihin ko na to, ang sige panganay na anak ng basketballistang si Eddie Laure. Mamaya will show the whole family sa inyo. 23-17. Ani mga bante ng Petron. Nga lang, ano, hindi pinalad si EJ sa kanyang service kanina.
Oo nga, lumabas.
Alright, CC. Defended well at the net.
Double.
Oh.
Kasi nagdalawang isip si Bea, whether she was gonna do an overhead set or underhand net. So, because of that delay, syempre, nung pag-set niya nung bola, wala na. Double na yun.
And every time you doubt what you're going to do, chances are, error ang kasunod na.
Oh.
CC, look at her jump! And check ball yan. So that point will go to Photon. Ibang hops nito. Partner, ibang hops ni CC Rondino.
Oh, iba nga. Maganda pag-aralan natin ang kanyang foot movements.
18 serving 24, Photon down by 6.
Oh!
Uh-oh.
Ano ba? Alam mo, kanina sabi sa akin ni Coach George, alam mo, hindi muna kami magko-combination plays yun, mga basic plays lang.
Eto.
Eh, oo nga, ilan na, nakakailan na sila.
I think you've pointed out 2 or 3 already.
Yeah, but you know, it's really good to watch combination plays executed by teams.
Palma, almost scoring on that one. Another chance here for Petron. At sabi ni Pons, mabawi naman. Mabawi ako sa error ko kanina. That's it for set 1. 25-19 ang ating score lamang. Or lamang ng 6. Panalo ng 6 in set 1 ang Petron. That's a nice hit. Nice set. Nice finish coming from Bernadette Pons. 25-19 in set number 1. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Pabalik po ang show dito sa May San Juan Arena para po sa PSL All-Filipino Conference 2016 as we'll show you the highlights of our first set kung saan sa unang bahagi ng set number 1, palitan ng puntos ang naganap sa pagitan ng Petron at Colton, CC Rondina there, Chiqui Pablo jumping high, celebrating that point. Pero at the end of that set, it was the defending champs winning it 25-19.
Yes, because itong defending champs natin, they were not afraid to come up with combination plays. They did not just go to one player in Isa Pontillas. AC Masangkay was so good in distributing her sets. So as you can see in the statistics, ang attacks ng Petron was so much higher than Photon simply because Bang Pineda also did a great job in the floor defense. Service aces were there because loaded yung mga services nila. Pero wow, yung unforced errors naman ng Petron, napakalaki at 10 compared to only 5 of Photons. But you know, one thing that I like about Petron is they're very quick to recover from mistakes.
Yes.
And they never say die. So kahit na ba nilabangan sila at one point ng Photon kanina, walang kaso. Kahit na ba nag-iba-iba ng tao sa loob ang Photon, walang kaso. Because they know each other.
Yes.
And they move like a family inside the court.
So masasabi natin hindi nami-miss yung mga pangalang binanggit natin at the top of the coverage.
Yeah, and you know, the shuffle of Coach George not starting with Jen Reyes as libero.
That's
diba?
Right.
Tapos, hindi siya takot. Talagang linabas niya si Remy Palma and Bernadette Pons. Eh, mga ano to, rookies.
Mga rookie,
yeah.
Mga baguhan.
Oh, diba? So, maganda yung shuffle, pagka-shuffle ni Coach George. Now, itong Photon, they did a great job din naman kaninang first set. Gumagalaw sila, may communication. Kailangan lang iwasan yung mga ganong errors sa setups.
But you like what you're seeing from the Tornadoes?
Yes, of course. I like their movements. It's just that they have to be careful with Zone 6. Doon sila pinatay. There you go. Favorite Zone 5 and Zone 6 is the
favorite target.
Okay. Basta doon dalihin ng Petron, namamatay yung bola.
Nice working talaga with Chiqui Pablo, even the volleyball evangelist, Tech Suter. These guys know how to himayin itong larong ito. 1-0, set number 2, defending champs. Abante ng isa, si Tech Suter nag-aalok ng Chichilla dito. Okay.
Mamaya na yan, Tex.
You know why? This is a very festive San Juan Arena.
Yeah, that's right.
Actually, while Chiqui Pablo was talking, we were dancing right next to her. Because the atmosphere is so festive.
And you know, guys, if you can see the socks of Chiqui Reyes, polka dots, mga kaibigan.
Para tumir mo lang tayo dito. Palo ni Sisi, ang gandang depensa. Palma and Aisha on top of that hit.
Ang ganda, the block was there. Strong blockers coming from Petron. Sisi Rondina, hindi biro ang mga palo nito, but you can see that was a wall.
And that Petron Triactive block is brought to you by Petron. Petron Triactive fuels, better engine protection, better mileage, better power. So, wow.
Si AC ulit, delivering service aces. AC aces.
Kumurap lang tayo.
Oo.
Lamang na ng apat ang Petron, 4-0.
That was really fast.
All right, Masangkay kissing that ball. 4-0 at the net. Sabi ni Palma, no way is that ball gonna go back to our side.
You really have to have a good first ball because the blockers of Petron are tough.
Yung mga utak moves, ano? I mean, di makulangan wanting to go to that open space, but Palma was so quick. Running hit coming from Ortiz. Pero buhay pa rin ang bola. Ball goes back to the Tornado. CC. I like the energy.
But that ball of CC's hit the antenna.
Yun lang. 6-0. And that point pala went to Petron. Wala pang puntos dito ang Photon. Coach Millet, pakinggan po natin.
malikot. Pinapasabi talaga nila sa akin. Bakanting-bakanting yan, sino kukuha ng dola. Para sabi ko, makaharap tayo. Huwag na kumuha ng mga sumasabi sa mga.
Alright guys, copy tayo!
Tama ba ako? Parang Antonio ni Coach Villette, buti sana kung sila yung pumupuntos sa atin. Eh, tayo yung pumupuntos para sa kanila.
Oh, kasi alam ni Coach Villette na napakalalim, napakalakas ng team niya. So for them to just give away points like that, it's hard for the coach to take.
Hirap ang kapit.
Yes, and of course, rinimind din niya si Dimakulangan na huwag tatalikuran ng bola.
Tandaan mo, nung set number one, in fact, photo nakakuha ng kalamangan ng unang technical timeout.
Okay.
So, ibig sabihin na kaya talaga nila maglaro. But here in the second set, nabulaga sila ng 6-0 run ng Petron.
Oh, ito talagang, Petron, pag sila ang kalaban mo, huwag ka kukurap.
Wag. Ay, mahirap yun. Mahirap yun. Okay. It's one serving six. Rhea with that serve. Ball is alive. Side ng Petron. Palma almost scoring on that hit. And Masangkay apologizing to Coach George for that misreception there.
And sometimes you need a 1-2 offense. That was nicely done by Cici Rondina.
So two straight points coming from Fulton to cut down the lead of Petron down to 4. Rhea pa rin nag-serve for Fulton, but that's a service error, giving Petron their 7th point. 7-2. Remy Palma serving for Petron, one of the rookies ng Tri-Active Spikers.
Let's see if she can control her ball this time. Yeah, oh, she did.
Mas mahina-hina na.
Oh.
Cici jumping high again. Meantime, the veteran, ang kapitan, pinatama ang bola. Lumabas, and that point will go to Petron. Anima kanilang abante. 8-2 ang ating score. First technical timeout of set number 2.
Welcome back to the Philippine Super League All-Filipino Conference 2016 here on Action TV, the Philippine Olympic Network. Jen Reyes had conflicted feelings coming into today's game because as you've seen, for the first time in a long time, hindi siya ang naging starting libero para dito sa Petron Tri-Active Spikers. Pero as a team veteran, alam naman niya that she needs to make way for Bang Pineda in order for Bang to build her confidence as a libero. Pero at the same time, nararamdaman rin niya na natcha-challenge siya na mag-step up ni Coach George Pascua. Chiki and Chiki?
The girls.
Yes.
Salamat, Carla. Ano yan, no? It's a girl thing.
You know, it's a woman healthy competition, di ba?
Yeah, kidding lang, kidding. Dahil ang ganda ng report ni Carla.
Oh, you really have to step because both teams are so fully equipped. So, kailangan talaga hindi ka papatay-patay, even in training, di ba? Kasi kung hindi, you will lose your spot.
Yes.
But I'm not saying na si Jen nagpapatay-patay siya. That's why I'm lose, ano, ah. So I just want to be clear on that.
And I like to hear the honesty coming from Jen's side.
Yeah.
Nandun yung team na inuuna niya. Nandun yung pagmamahal kay Bang para maka-adjust.
Yes.
But at the same time, hey, you're challenging me.
Yeah.
I also want to get my minutes. I also want
that's
to get
right.
that spot. And that's normal for any team.
That's right. Kasi kahit diba, sinong player, diba, you want the
yes.
minutes.
Wow. 9-3, the beauty of Philippine Super League, mga kaibigan. All-Filipino Conference 2016. As we go back to live action, El Capitan with that soft touch. And Aisha is giving everyone a good look of what she is delivering right now. A little bit of everything, power and finesse.
That's right. And she can deliver cross-court, down the line, hard hit, and soft touch. Lahat nakakapuntos basta galing sa kamay niya.
At lamang sila ng pito, 10-3. Quick one there, para kay Ortiz. Ganda pa rin ang depensa ng Petron,
nice.
But that time around, Ortiz said, oh no, we gotta stop this.
Yun talaga, hindi niya pwede palagpasin doon. Ang ganda ng setup sa kanya eh, nung regalong yun.
And if you get a gift,
yeah,
take it.
Take it.
Check, hindi ko masyadong naramdaman nga si Jaja nung ano, set one.
That's right. Eh, kasi, ang dami nilang go-to players.
Ba.
Kaya tingnan natin ngayon, mararamdaman ba natin siya.
So Aiza scoring again, this one off a check ball. 11-4, Petron still up.
Alam mo, malayo pa yan sa 25. Kaya pang umabol ng Photon.
Oh, yes.
They just put their minds to it.
But it has to start here. Quick one to Jaja, pero nandun pa rin depensa ng Petron. And Morada knew it. Pag-angat pa lang niya, the defense of Photon was already there.
Nabasa kasi ng defense ng Photon si Micah Morada. Micah is not really a tall player for middle. At katapat niya si Jaja. So kailangan gumawa ng play si AC na maloko ang defense like that. Nicely done. Oo, ang bilis. Oo, bilis ng galaw ng utak ni AC, di ba? At ang ginamit niya si Micah because Micah was the one who's previously blocked.
Setting that one up. Off the deflection, another point for Micah Morada. Meantime, zone one was open. Too big a space for Jaja.
Right, pero hinihintay ko pa yung palo ni Jaja na talagang pamatay na palo.
Yung kanina, diba? Nung set one, pwede na ba yun yung unang ginawa niya? Hindi pa rin yun.
Meron pa eh. Meron pa siyang
sibat?
Ibibigay. Oh, meron pa siyang ha? Ibibigay.
Baka nga natin mamaya yan. Ha? Molina, sa kabila naman, Santiago. One more time for the captain. 12-6, Petron, abante ng anim. AC will set. Molina will score.
Nice combination play there called by AC. Jumping up and down on your screen. Excited siya doon. There's the decoy. Yun. Ang laki ng utas dun sa blocks.
Pero kahit hindi tumalon yung depensa ng Photon, nagulat sila dun sa combination play na yun, ano?
Maganda nga yung pagkatawag ni AC dun sa play na yun. And that was well read by Remy Palma.
I thought that was a bit far para kay Jaja. Hinabol na lang, ano? At the net and the... And in the process, adam na ni Remy Palma. Aamin to.
Right. This 3-9 nga isave ni Jaja yun eh. Linihis niya yung bola, kaya lang the blockers were there.
14-6. Pinakamalaking kalamangan ito ng Petron sa set number 2. CC. Going high for that hit.
Alam mo, pag tinitingnan mo yung mukha ni CC Rondina, never say die yun eh. Never say give up.
Ang taas talaga tumalon eh.
Ang taas talaga tumalon. Parang feeling ko pag tumalon ka, pwede ka tumalon siya, pwede ka pa magkape sa ilalim.
Pwede. Magmerienda. But Jaja, that's a service error, giving a free point to Petron. They're up 15-7.
Too many service errors coming from Photon. They have to put a stop on that because they're giving free points to their opponent.
Masangkay will serve. Back set by Perez. And smart thinking coming from the captain. Not the most beautiful hits, pero effective. 16-7, sila ang lamang. We'll be right back. Si Eddie daw rin po yan. At kasama ang kanyang may bahay na si Jody Laure. At lahat pala ng kanilang mga anak, letter E, ang pangalan. Oh, na naikwento sa akin ni Eddie yan. Si Jovi pala yung kanyang may bahay. Si EJ, yung panganay. Yung isa pang babae is Aya. Yung dalawang anak pa nila, lalaki, Echo and Efo.
Echo?
Oo. At tinanong ko si Eddie, saan ba natuto maglaro ng volleyball itong si EJ Laure? Sabi niya sa kanya. Dahil nung high school si Eddie Laure, he used to play volleyball and basketball for Punta National High School sa Zamboanga del Norte.
Wow!
So tanong ko noon, ano ba, rally point na noon? Tumawa siya sa akin. Sabi niya, Padre, side out pa noon. Side out pa daw. And Mr. and Mrs. Laure, by the way, will celebrate the birthday for Jovi, July 5, si Eddie, July 6.
You know, they look so young to be the parents of, ano,
oh, si Eddie naglaro yan sa Batangas Blades before moving to the PBA. And then, Mahindra yung kanyang huling stint.
There you go.
17-8, Petron up. CC. And very resilient itong manlalarong ito. Perez will set. Too easy for Petron. The captain once more trying to take advantage. Rondina, inaabangan na si CC sa kanyang palo.
Oo nga, pero ito nga si Rondina always finds a way. Pag nagkamali, nakaka-recover right away. And you know, itong si Ivy Perez, she was awarded as the second best setter during the 2015 Grand Prix. So hindi biro-biro na nasa floor si Ivy Perez for Photon.
And I'll agree with you, I like the lineup of Photon. I'm sure after this game, both teams or even first two teams that played earlier, adjustments will be made.
Oh yeah, definitely yun.
Dahil nakita na yun ng mga veterano, may mga bagong mga, aba, hindi pala, magaling pala ito, ang lakas kumain talaga ng ating kaibigan dito. Alright, 18-9.
Nagulat ako, bigla ngayon donut na ba
na? Mr. Tech Suter still working here, trying to watch every game. Ganyan po ka-dedicated ang ating mga analysts dito. AC will set. Molina with a hit. Perez, siya naman sa kabila. From the back!
Oh, finding the corner! Goodness!
No. That was out.
Oh, I thought it hit the corner.
Ako rin eh. Ang angulo ko parang corner, but linesman said, wala. Outside yan. The hops of CC Rondina. Nagulat yata yung mga tao dito, hindi naka-cheer.
Oo nga.
19-9, 10-point lead for Petron. Set number 2. And the hit of Morada, hindi man lang lumampas. So that kinapos. Point will go to Fota.
Yeah, kinapos yung bola. Feel energy doon ni Maika, so she sits down first. And CJ Rosario takes her place as middle blocker.
Mike Ortiz. It's 10 serving. 19. Fulton down by 9. AC will set up. Great read. Great dig. Coming from CC. To the back. Triactive spikers to the captain. And Perez could not handle the hit.
Alam mo, nandun na si Perez eh, diagonal. Because she knows that when Pontilles hits the ball, bigger chances magda-diagonal yan. Yeah. Then down the line. But the ball was just too powerful for her.
Good observation. We were calling it nung set number 1. Puro cross-court na, no?
Oh.
Si Aiza. Meantime, Jaja naman scoring on that one. Let's check in on Carla Lizardo.
Checky and checky. Kwento ni Coach George Pascua na nung lumipat yung ibang star players ng Petron, their fan base was also cut in half. Napakalaking bagay ng fans para sa kanila, so that serves as a challenge for this newer lineup na ipakita sa fans that they still have the same championship attitude and that they are still a team to root for. Back to you guys.
I like that report. Maraming salamat, Carla. Nahati na ang fans, no? Pero siyempre, the coaches would tell the others na naiwan, huwag kayong mag-alala. We are still the same team.
Yeah, and this is a perfect chance for them to tell the fans na, hey, come on, you can still cheer for us. We're a good team as well.
And they have all the good reasons, no?
Yeah.
Para supportan sila. 2012, Petron 8 ang kanilang abante.
Miscommunication there.
CJ will score another one for Petron. That's a net violation ng Photon. CJ Rosario will be serving for the Triactive Spikers. No.
Maika Morada will return. She has had her rest. Kasi magaling mag-serve si Maika. Nakaka-deliver siya ng ace.
Maika Morada. Good serve there.
Yun! Yun yung inahanap ko.
Inahanap mo.
Napalo. Yung mga ganun yung kailangan nating makita pa.
One more look. Power's there.
And she, you know, she didn't even jump to her peak. Talagang kontrolado pa yung jump niya. Can you just imagine kung talagang...
And they need more of those.
Oh.
Plus, siguro some errors from Petron para makahabol ang photo.
That's right. So, EJ Laureo is now coming back. So, upo muna ngayon si CC Rondina.
Tingnan natin kung makakahabol dito ang photo. They're down by 7. Masangkay. Back set to Palma. And Palma's feeling it. Alam mo, after that first error ng set 1, wala na, no looking back for Remy.
Talaga, okay, hindi ko na i-commit in the same mistake. That's a good mindset. Everybody should have that kind of mindset. Even if you're not a volleyball player, diba? If you make a mistake in life, recover right away.
She reminds me of a Honey Roy Stombino, yung built.
Oh, yeah.
Balikat.
Oh.
Meantime, Pons asking for a check ball. Pero sabi ng ating second referee na si referee Jess, nope. Out.
Yeah, pagka ganun, let it go. Total, you won the first set, you're leading in the second set. stamina and let it go, or else it'll affect your game.
15 serving 22. Pitong abante pa rin ng Petron.
Wow, good hustle there by Remy. Ha? And, you know, she's not a small player. She's a big player, and yet she hustles.
At buti, nakailag yung ating cameraman sa ibaba.
That's right.
Because these players, walang sasantuhin yan. Oh. We've seen that when we were covering sa may floor area, di ba?
That's right.
Any loose ball, they don't care if there's a monitor in front of them kung may cameraman dyan.
Ahabulin nila yan.
23-16. Masakai will be serving for the Triactive Spikers. Good serve again by AC. It's an ace. May effect kaya yung paghalik ni
sa bola?
AC sa bola.
Ah, yung timeout ng Photon. That's a good call. Break the momentum.
24-16, Petron still up. Coach Villet, pakinggan natin. I will try to get the audio. Check in that huddle.
Yep.
Parang wala, hindi naman hinahabol ni Coach Villet yung panalunin niyo yung second set. She was looking for the energy.
Yeah.
Present nung set one, naglaho parang bula ngayong set two.
Yeah, tapos yung sinabi niya, pataasin lang natin yung numero.
Para mag-carry over sa set 3.
Yeah, so that they can get have some kind of momentum going into the third set. That's a good play there from Ivy Perez. Oh, ang ganda. Right away, creating a point after that crucial timeout.
Beware of the setter.
Yeah.
They're very deceptive.
Yeah. Totoo yun.
Dami nating nakitang ganyan, di ba?
Oh, dami. Magic ang kamay niya.
Kala mo si Seth.
Tapos pala.
Babalik sa Yogan on the second ball. 17 serving 24. Perez with a serve. Palma. This time around, squalado yung palo. So that's it here in set number 2. 2-0 ang kanilang kalamangan. Sa set count, 25-17 naman ang final score ng set 2. We'll take another look at this great hit by Palma. That's a great angle, but here's a nicer angle. The hops, the hit, the cross court, and that's set number 2 for Petron. Set 3 when we return. Babalik po ang inyong PSL All-Filipino Conference 2016. Bakbakan ng Petron at ng Photon Tornado. Set number 2 highlights. It was a quick start for Petron. Chiki going 6-0. And from that 6-0 start, they never look back.
Yeah, ginulat talaga ng Petron ang Photon with such an aggressive move. Such aggressive moves from the attack zone, blocking, services. Nakakailang ace, service aces sila. The distribution of the sets, the combination plays. But as you look at your screens, nagkaroon ng malaking adjustments ang Photon because ang attack points, pinantayan nila ang Petron. However, ang Petron na naig pa rin sila sa service aces and blocks, and there were just too many service errors from Photon, and I think that's mostly what is composed in the number 8 sa unforced errors nila. Too many service errors.
And that Bulaga move, ano?
That Bulaga move.
Coach George Pasco and the rest of the Triactive Spikers, that 6-0 start nila ng second set.
Oh.
I think yun yung sinasabi ni Coach Villet in one of their timeouts ng Tornadoes. Nasaan yung energy?
Right.
Hindi naman pwedeng one set lang kayo magko-compete. And to your point, look, you got EJ Laure, no, you got the ladies of Coach Villet. The lineup is solid.
Yes.
Hindi naman sila. I will now say, with or without reinforcements, Photon is a team, one of the teams to beat here All-Filipino Conference.
I totally agree. Maybe their gelling is not as good as they want it all to be. But ang remedyo doon, mag-usap kayo sa court. You have to talk inside the court, communicate. Talk about anything. Talk about who's going to hit, ano yung play na tatawagin. Mga ganun, kahit ano, pag-usapan nyo.
Now, we've seen weirder things happen in the sport of volleyball. You're down 0-2. sa set count and all of a sudden, pagkurap mo, 3, 4, and 5, napunta sa inyo. Yung unang nanalo ng two sets, biglang nawalan ng gasolina.
Oh, ilang beses nangyayari yun, di ba? Dito sa Philippine Superliga. Ito, this was a good block. Kaya lang sa sobrang lakas ng bola ni Laure, umoutside ang ball.
So Photon gets the first point here in set 3. Pons of the deflection will get that point back. And we are tied at 1 apiece.
No, Bernadette Pons did a smart move there. Nag-off the block siya. Nakita niya ang tatangkad ng blockers niya. Ivy Perez and Jaja Santiago. But you have to earn a point. So, off the block.
AC will serve for Petron. Another good serve coming from Masangkay. Laure, again, off the deflection. And I'm looking at the parents. No reaction from Eddie and Jovi.
Oh, siguro kinakabahan.
Baka?
Oo.
Normal din siguro sa kanila. Ivy Perez, sabi mo mahusay na setter for Photon.
Oh yeah, and even when there were reinforcements, she scored a lot from the service zone. Ayan, exactly.
And she made you look good.
Yeah, she made me look good that time.
Alas, para kay Perez.
Mabigat ang kamay ni Perez sa service eh. Nakakatakot ang mga bola niya sa service.
And the crowd of the Tornadoes are live here at San Juan Arena. By the way, live po itong inyong napapanood sa Action TV, ang ating Philippine Olympic Network. Reyes, Pablo, and Lizardo, ang inyong TV broadcast team. At sabi nga natin, Philippine Olympic Network tayo. Huwag kalilimutan.
Yes,
sa Agosto yan, Olympics. Pero bago niyan, Olympic qualifying tournament muna sa July. Okay. And
that's an overreaching, said the referee. Because si Ivy Perez just wanted to save that first ball. Eh. Error yun sa reception. Eh. But the first referee, Jojo Isidro, said, nope, no can do.
Nope, nope. Alas, galing kay Relly Palma. And the lead swings to Petron. Three straight points coming from the Tri-Active Spikers.
Which the Photon Tornadoes have to put a stop.
Yes. What you don't want is a repeat of set 2.
Right, right.
Nabigla silang gagawa ng 6-point lead. And Jaja ties it at 4.
Ito kasi parehong inyo Bulldogs itong si Ivy Perez and... Oh my goodness, I think AC hit her mouth on the floor.
Trying to save that ball. We'll see. From this angle. No.
Ah, banggaan. Oh my goodness.
Collision.
Hit. Oh.
So trying to ask the coaching staff, sila Coach George, kung dumudugo. Hindi gumalaw yung mga coach. Sabi nila, ayos lang yan.
Oh, at pag player ka, kahit na dumudugo ka, hindi ka lalabas. Ayaw mong lumabas.
Ana Grace is shaking it off.
She's shaking it off.
Meantime on the other side, Laure with the serve. We are tied at 4 here in set 3.
Wow, nicely done by Isa Portilla. Smart move.
Nakita niya. Go ahead.
Yeah, nakita niya kasi. Nandun na yung blockers. Nakatapat sa kanya. So, redirect niya yung bola. Iniwasan niya yung blockers. Wow. Ang ganda ng bagsak sa zone 4.
And she saw that yung space kung saan babagsak in the libero si Acevedo, medyo malayo-layo.
Right. Again, Maizo Portillas. Delivering that point for Petron. Again, playing with the blockers of Photon. Kaya nga sinabi ni Coach Binet kanina, mas ano, harder blocks, hindi malambot.
Yun. Oo nga, no? Yung the attack wasn't that strong.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Coming from the captain.
Oh, placement eh.
But if the block is not strong as well,
that's right.
Chances are, tatarang lang palabas yan. This time around, Patty gives a point to Photon. They're fifth here in set 3.
You know, Patty is also one of the players whom I think is a smart and has a high IQ in volleyball.
5-6. Tornadoes down by 1. AC back set. Mababa ang palo ni Aiza.
So si AC dapat i-distribute niya yung sets niya, hindi lang puro kay Contilias because we've got Cez Molina in front and Micah Murad in the middle.
Now, this is a good sign for Photon. Okay, you're down by 2, tatablahin mo as you go through set number 3. What you don't want is for Petron to have a good, comfortable lead. And if you can get the lead yourself, by all means. Ayan na. Photon is up, 7-6.
Ngayon, nagkakaroon na ng reception errors ang Petron. They have to wake up from that. Kasi sunod-sunod na rin si Photon kung pumuntos.
It's 7 serving 6. Chacha serving for the Tornadoes. Masangkay setting up. That's out. At labang dito ang Photon sa ating set 3. 8-6 ang ating score. May technical timeout tayo. We'll be right back. Let's talk about Aiza Maiso Pontillas. Paborito niyang galaw, cross court. Pero pag nalin lang ka, dumadown the line minsan. Pag hindi mo abangan, tirahan ka ng malapot. A little bit of everything. Aiza Maiso Pontillas ng Petron Triactive Spikers.
Tsaka magaling siya magbasa ng blockers, magaling magbasa ng defense. Poker yung face niya, di ba? You can't really tell what she's thinking. But talagang AD siya parate. So you know, as a captain, she's not really that talkative.
Yes.
But she shows her command through her actions.
By example, ano?
Oh.
So the captain is indeed at work. Pero sa kabila naman, Ortiz defending that side of the court really well. Giving another point to Photon.
Basang-basa ang offensive play ng Petron.
So lamang na dito ng tatlo ang Tornadoes. And hindi ko pa natatapos yung sentence. That ball sailed out already.
So rewind. Lamang na.
Dalawa. Ang Photon. 9-7. Aiza with the serve. Running hit.
Whoa!
Ni Ortiz.
What a hit by Ortiz. I mean, that was fierce. You could see it in her face. You could hear the ball when she hit that. And it just went through the blocks. Look at this.
And she's doing a Remy Palma on the side of Photon. Sila yung mga...
Yeah, there you go.
Nagpa-pump up na kanila mga kakampi. Mula sa likod, si Pons. Zone 1. Target ni Pons, pasok.
No, Cerveza was there. If she had just moved one step to the right, she could have gotten that ball.
So Mina Ganon will be replacing Cesc Molina. Chen Unag will be serving for Petron. They're down by 2. Tornadoes on the attack. Meantime, Petron naman. Aiza. And I think that deflection, na iba yung depensa bigla ng Photon, ano?
And, you know, that's also the reason why you have to be on your toes. Para mas mabilis yung galaw mo. Mas mabilis ka makaka-adjust dun sa mga palit ng direction ng bola.
Hindi ready si Carol nun, eh.
Cerveza,
that's
yes.
Right. Isa na lang abante dito ng Photon. Angat muling sa dalawa.
Nice.
As Patty Orendain scores for the Tornadoes.
Yes, that was a nice move by Patty Orendain. She saw that AC's a smaller blocker. She played with the blockers off the block, letting it go through AC Masangkay.
Orendain serving. It's 11, serving 9. AC, quick one to Palma. Ano ba nangyari doon?
Ano mo yung bola? Parang pumasok na eh.
Diba?
Pumasok na eh. Alam din ni Remy, kaya natawa siya eh.
So that point will go
to AC. To AC.
Hindi nang makikredit yung point na yan.
Oo, kay AC. Siya yung nakapasok ng bola at nakapuntos.
Napangiti si Remy doon. Alright, lead is down to 1. Back set to Ortiz. Masangkay going to Palma. Favorite recipient. Zone 5 was open.
Ang ganda naman ng running ni Remy. Kaya nga, Bez, kanina kasi, di ba, minention na natin eh, one of the rookies that you should really look out for is Remy Palma.
The timing.
Yes. The confidence.
The confidence being displayed by Palma right now. But DJ Laure making her presence felt as well.
Yeah. Her confidence also, slowly but surely, lumalabas. Iniwasan niya yung mga blockers.
Dinaan sa kaliwang kamay
lihis
ni Remy Palma. AC going to Pons, and again zone one.
Mike Ortiz just looked at that ball. She didn't even move. So kailangan nga on your toes para mas mabilis yung spring ng galaw ng paa.
If you're down 0-3 set count, exchanging points, tapos tabla pa, not in favor of the Tornadoes. Jaja, nice to see a long, lean, and tall player doing that,
yeah,
instead
very,
of puro power.
Oh, very graceful the way she did it pa.
So ang kalamangan, balik po sa Photon 13-12 as Perez will be serving for the Tornadoes. May fan base na si Ivy rin dito.
Oh, malakas sila. Oh!
Parang konti na lang, ano? Abot sana pa on the other side. But we are tied at 13.
You know, Photon has to win this set. So kailangan mas aggressive ang galaw nila. Mas quick to receive those balls. Tsaka wala nang assuming that it's gonna go out. Habulin yung bola.
Good serve by Palma.
Good setup.
And net defense, mag-isa lang si Chetunag. But no problem.
Oh, nabasa kasi ni Nunag ang galaw ni Cerveza. That's why, that was a great block by Nunag.
Lee goes back to Petron. Single coverage lang.
Oh.
Petron up 14-13. Ace! Oh!
Oh, I thought
Sorry.
That ball landed inside the court, but...
Not second-guessing the linesmen or the officials. But out! 14-all is our score.
Here we go. Ooh, that's a good service ace there by Laure.
So 15-14 in favor of Photon. Akala ko eh, yung ano, angulo sa akin. Ikaw ba?
Akala ko...
Pasok din yung kanya. Okay.
Ang lakas ng bola.
Oh, great serve.
Yes.
Nunag. Boy pa rin ang bola. Patty gives Photon a two-point lead, 16-14. Pangalawang technical timeout ng set number three. One more look at this great hit coming from Patty. They're up. Here in set three, kinakailangan maisalba nila ito. 16-14. We'll be right back. Mga kapatid, magandang anunsyo po ito sa Middle East. Mapapanood nyo na ang PSL Live via Action TV International. At sa mga kababayan natin sa US at Canada, mapapanood ninyo din ang PSL sa Kapatid TV5. Wow. So all over.
Oh.
All over na ito.
Thank you for watching.
Yes.
The Philippine Super League, everybody.
So, Chick.
Yes.
Unang technical timeout natin ng set 3. Photon was off to a good start getting that 8-6. Mm-hmm. Pero pagdating ng second technical timeout, ito ang Petron. Umahabol na. They're only down by one.
That's right. Kaya itong Photon, kailangan mas creative sila sa plays, mas confident and accurate yung mga hits. And they have to have a good first ball so Jaja can do her thing in the middle.
Action continues. Jaja with a hit. Pineda going to Aiza. And Aiza will tie it at 16.
You know ang Petron, kapag namimiligro or kapag kailangan nila ng puntos, their go-to person is really Aiza Potillas. Because whatever ball you give her, she'll give the point for you.
The captain of the ship.
Yes.
Tabla tayo, 16. And net infraction according to referee Jojo. So the point will go to Petron. Lamang na sila dito, Chicky P, 17-16.
Photon needs to calm down. It seems like they're already panicking inside the court. They have to get it together, talk to each other, and take this 1 point at a time.
Patina ganon gives Petron a two-point lead. You're right, ano? Prior to that, the two straight points ng Petron, or three straight points sila, the energy was there for Photon.
Yeah, the energy was there, but parang nagkakagulo eh yung mga plays nila. And the blocks, kailangan mas closer together para hindi nakakablusot yung bola.
Well, let me correct myself. Four straight points pala ng Petron coming from the second technical timeout. Photon. They got to stop the bleeding here. Off the block. Point again for Petron. 5 straight points coming from that second technical timeout ng set number 3. 19-16, Petron up. Coach Villette, pakinggan natin.
Anak nyo, sobrang taas naman. Kita nyo sa mga bumabagsak yung bola dito. Inatay lang nila yung umangat yung kamay niyo tsaka natin nila papaluin. At yan, babagsak lang niya sa atin. Kailangan dito tumatama yung block na yan. Ano yan? Dapat na tayo nag-dominate. Paano, asan tayo, nakatayo tayo? Sunod-sunod doon na error lang yan.
Check. Give us a quick volleyball 101. Bakit pag blocker ka, gusto mo sa palad, ayaw mo sa forearms?
Para mas nakokontrol mo yung bola.
Okay.
That's why it's very crucial yung timing, yung basa mo ng bola, yung talon mo, kung kailan ka magpa-block, dapat nandun. Kasi if the ball hits your hands, you can redirect it, you can score from a block compared to just getting hit sa arm.
And Coach Villette pointing that out earlier. Timing is crucial. 19-17. Petron Abante pa rin ang dalawa. Sa kabila naman, Jaja Santiago will be serving for the Tornadoes. Ball is alive. Aiza defended well at the net. AC will go to Aiza again. May nampalo. Another point for Photon. So, isa na lang ang hinahabol dito ng Tornadoes, partner. 19-18 ang ating score.
That's good. So, now they have to take advantage of that.
Jaja again. AC. Cross court. It's in.
What an angle by Mina Ganon. That was a good hit. Cross court hit. Kabisadong kabisado niya yung bola niya.
2018, Petron up by 2. And that's an infraction. That's right.
You know, those are the things that you don't need at a time like this. But mahihirapan talaga si Ivy Perez i-save yung bola if the first balls are really very close to the net.
21-18 is our score. Inuunti-unti dito ng Triactive Spikers, Chicky P. Ang kanilang pagkuha ng set 3, but Patty Orendain says otherwise.
Ang ganda ng palo ni Patty Orendain. Na talagang on top of the ball yung kamay niya. Pamatay. So ngayon, papasok si Cici Rondina and Patty Orendain are both in front. So if you can remember, they were partners during the beach volleyball
yes.
tournament. So let's see if they can contribute together in front.
Matagal na paupo si Cici.
Oo.
So let's see kung meron bang epekto yan na matagal kang nakaupo.
Yung, gutom. Gutom oh, to play. Oh.
Or nanlamig. We'll see.
Or that, yeah.
They're down by 2. 19, serving 21. Masangkay will go to Nunang. Chance here for Photon to score. From the back, nakagawan sa bola. Ayos pa rin. Nunang, scoring off the deflection. Ball dropped in. So Petron up by 3. At tatlo na lang ang kailangan nilang iscorein para makakuha ng straight sets victory.
You know, that's why you need to communicate inside the court. You can't have two hitters hitting the ball at the same time. Nawawala yung effectivity ng play eh.
Chen Unang will be serving 22, serving 19. Buti nga ka mo, pumasok pa rin yung bola eh.
Buti
going
nila.
To your point. Alright, Tornadoes. They'll try again. Cici goes to the back. Che was there. Back set. Mina Ganon. Hindi pa pagod to eh.
Hindi pa.
23-19. Mina gives Petron a 4-point lead. Coach Villette calling probably isa sa mga huling timeout dito sa set 3. Pakinggan natin siya. Bago yan muna. Ito muna. One more look. At Mina's hit. Different angle. Same result. Apat ang abante ng Triactive Spikers. Alright, Coach Villette, let's listen in. Yung kasabihan na when your men are down in the trenches and things are not falling into place, sometimes what they need is just a pat on the back. In that timeout, it's Coach Villet egging her players down to stay in the game.
Yeah, stay in the game. You know, it's 19-23, so pwede pa.
Anything that can happen, that's right. At the net, Regalo.
See, like what we said, anything can happen. So now it's 20-23. They have to put the service in. Patty Orinde in has a tough responsibility right now.
Down by three. Play ng depensa, nakita ninyo. Ano, offensa rather. Three ball. Triactive spikers. Sa kabila naman, wise move coming from Michelle Laure.
It wasn't really a planned move, I think, but it worked for Photon. Good job from EJ Laure.
Ano yun? Ano, Uwido? Correct. Music.
Oh.
But you have to take what whatever's given you on the floor. That time around, another donut.
Smart move from Ina Agano. Nakita niya umatras eh, yung defense ng Photon, expected her to hit that ball hard. So she redirected that ball, landed it on zone 6.
Lumuwang yung defense. Oh, by the time they saw where the ball was going, late na yung reaction. Match point here for Petron. Will they finish it? Palma says, nope, di pa. Laure. EJ will try again.
Oh.
And that's it. Straight set victory for Petron. Third set, 25-21. And the defending champions, check, they're sending a loud message to everyone dito sa All Filipino Conference. We are ready to defend the crown.
That's right. You know, Petron did a good job. Even with a different set of first six, it was a good combination from Coach George. Photon did a good job as well. They were answering the hard hits of Petron. Kulang lang sila sa zone six, defending zone six. And the service errors were the ones that really, really pulled them down.
And Coach George Pascual doing high fives, giving high fives. Look at our player, his players having fun here. 25-19, 25-17, 25-21. Straight sets victory para sa Triactive Spikers. But you can't take away anything sa Photon Tornado. Sa ito, kasama na ni Carla ang ating MVP of the match. Go ahead, Carla.
We are here with our MVP of the match, Aiza Maiso Potillas, with 15 attacks and 1 block. Aiza, dito sa laro na to, at the start, kita natin match na match ang Petron at ang Photon. Ano yung naging turning point for you guys to run away with a three-set victory?
Siguro yung focus lang namin sa loob ng court, ina-enjoy namin. At pinag-uusapan namin kung ano mga kulang namin sa loob ng court.
So itong panalo na to, does it set the tone para dito sa Petron na ganito yung magiging performance nyo dito sa All Filipino Conference?
Sana magtuloy-tuloy pa at maganda pa yung ipapakita ng team namin.
Bilang match MVP, meron ko bang gustong batiin?
Best second run, thank you Lord. At binabati ko yung Petron Corporation, family ko na sa Pasig City, Iloilo. Mga magkaanak ko, Fortes family, Maiso family, Pontillas family. Thank you po.
Thank you so much. Once again, congratulations. Balik sa inyo, check in.
Maraming salamat, Carla Lizardo. Good job, by the way, manning the sides. This is where we end our coverage. Para po kay Ron, kay Koy, kay Direk Arvin, my partners here, Carla Lizardo, the good Chicky, Chicky Pablo, ito po si Chicky Ray saying thank you very much for watching the PSL All-Filipino Conference 2016. Ito ang Volleyball!